You may not realize it, but there are 8,300 artificial satellites orbiting Earth right now, with 3,000 of these currently not operational. So how do these stay up orbiting Earth when we know things should fall down due to gravity? If you want to escape Earth's gravity, you have to fly at just over 40,000 kilometers per hour. The point of a satellite, though, isn't to escape gravity, it's to orbit Earth, which means that you want to have just the right orbital velocity to balance gravity. If a satellite was to begin to slow down, it would slowly begin to curve towards Earth until eventually colliding with Earth. This is why you need to have everything balanced, otherwise you'll end up colliding with Earth or going too fast and will just fly away. The International Space Station is an artificial satellite which you can see above you when it flies past, due to it being in a low orbit. The International Space Station travels at 27,000 kilometers per hour, which means it can orbit Earth every 93 minutes. Your average GPS satellite, which you use when you try to find your location on your phone, travels at 14,000 kilometers per hour, which is slower than the International Space Station due to it traveling at a higher altitude. If you were to look up, there are at least 4 GPS satellites somewhere above you, and there's up to 12 above you at one time. The higher the altitude of a satellite, the slower it can travel to orbit Earth. This is due to there being less gravity attracting you to Earth the further away you get from Earth. That's why the Moon, which is our only natural satellite, travels much slower than the International Space Station and the GPS satellite. Be sure to subscribe and tell your friends about sciBRIGHT. It's great to see that this channel is growing, and we thank you very much for supporting us.